Greenheck, building value in air.
Hello, I'm Mike Carter, an application engineering specialist for Greenheck.
Today, we will be covering the installation procedure of the fire-ready range hood. Before beginning work on any equipment, it is important to adhere to safety standards. Be sure to wear the appropriate personal protection equipment. The product will arrive in a large carton on a pallet. First, thoroughly check to ensure all items are accounted for. There may be several boxes strapped to the product depending on what types of accessories were ordered. Bulky accessories such as ceiling enclosures may ship loose in separate boxes. Anything missing or damaged should be noted on the bill of lading. It is highly recommended to have a copy of the Installation and Operations Manual, IOM, on hand before arriving on site. The IOM contains important information regarding the installation, maintenance, and troubleshooting if needed. It also has copies of wiring diagrams that will help in the process of wiring the hood. A copy of this document ships in the product packaging and is also available at greenheck.com. Typically, the job of installing the hood is a responsibility of the mechanical contractor, but coordination between different trades is very important. One of the first things prior to hanging the hood is to determine the number of electrical circuits needed from the breaker panel to the hood. It is recommended that before drywall is hung, all electrical cables be run through the wall to their corresponding components. Determine the hood mounting height using guidelines of maximum spacing of 30 inches to a minimum of 24 inches from the bottom of the hood to the range top. Locate the hood mounting plate in the packaging and consult the IOM for dimensional data and details on installing the bracket. Attach the bracket to the wall in the desired location and securely fasten with the proper field-provided fasteners. Ensure the distance from the bottom of the bracket to the cooking surface is between 24 and 30 inches. Make sure the bracket is safely secured to the wall studs to prevent potential damage to the product or serious injury. The hood can weigh up to 93 pounds. If the hood was purchased with the available external inline fan option, it will need to be installed vertically or horizontally in the ductwork running between the unit and the roof or wall cap. Check that the fan is installed with the airflow arrow on the side of the fan directed away from the hood and in accordance with the information seen in the IOM. Attach the ductwork to the 8-inch collar adapter on the hood mounting bracket. Remove the hood from the crating and remove the grease filter. Carefully lift the hood into place onto the lower hood tabs on the wall mounting bracket with a helper. While supporting the hood, hook the safety cable to the chain link on the mounting bracket and screw the nut to close the link. The hood is now in the service position. Locate the range disconnect assembly and gas valve if applicable. Range disconnects are offered in either gas or electric configurations. There are two different types of range disconnect options. First is a gas range disconnect, which utilizes an external gas valve and also includes an electric disconnect, since many gas ranges have an electric power connection. The second disconnect option is used for an electric-only range. The disconnect should be mounted behind the range or in a cabinet next to the range. Dimensions for these components are shown in the IOM. Note the plug-and-play electrical cables for the disconnect are 10 feet long, so make sure to mount the disconnect close enough so that the cables will reach. We will cover wiring in more detail later. The hood seen here is configured with cabinets above it, but the fire-ready range hood is also available with several other accessories, such as ceiling enclosures or a finished top. Dimensional data and further installation details can be found in the IOM for these items. The fire-ready range hood features a plug-and-play design for simplicity and ease of installation. Cables are supplied with connectors on the ends, so it is important to size conduits adequately to allow the connectors to pass through unobstructed. A few connections will require wiring to be supplied in the field. You will need to run 115 volts AC from a 15 amp non-shunted breaker through a 1-inch knockout in the control J-box behind the hood mounting bracket, then into the hood. Terminate the hot on terminal H1, neutral on terminal N1, and ground on the green GND terminal. Make sure there is enough slack in the wiring to prevent tension on the wires when the hood is lowered into its service position. If the hood was provided with an internal fan, the fan is wired from the factory. If provided with an external inline fan, the hood will be provided with a 50-foot, four-wire plug-and-play cable with an orange label. Connect this cable to the orange plug and play harness at the fan. Run it down to the hood and through a 2-inch knockout in the controls J-box. Connect the orange plug-and-play harness in the hood. For a fan by others, there will also be a 50-foot, four-wire plug-and-play cable, the same as discussed previously. Connect the harness to the orange plug existing in the hood, and then connect the 1-foot fan harness extension to the fan side, as shown here. For a gas range disconnect, if the gas range has a 115-volt AC cord, plug this cord in here to the receptacle labeled range. Then plug the gas valve 1.5-foot whip into the 5-foot gas valve cord coming off the bottom of the gas disconnect assembly. Plug in the gas disconnect 5-foot power cord to an 115-volt receptacle near the range. Next, there will be two plug-and-play 10-foot cables coiled up in the hood. Run these through a 2-inch knockout in the control J-box down to the gas shutoff assembly, connecting them here on the disconnect. For the electric range disconnect assembly, start by plugging the disconnect 2.5-foot, four-prong power cord into a 250-volt AC receptacle near the range. Then connect the range power cord into the 250-volt AC receptacle on the disconnect. Lastly, you will connect the two 10-foot plug-and-play cables similar to as we described earlier with the gas disconnect. Simply find the cables coiled up in the hood and run them down to the disconnect to plug in here. Now we'll run through some of the connections and a few of the options and accessories. For more details on other accessories not covered in this video, please consult the IOM. A manual pull station can be supplied for fire suppression system activation. To connect this accessory, plug the 30-foot plug-and-play cable into the remote pull plug housing on the fire suppression control board here. If supply fan interlock control capability is desired, this can be accomplished by using the supply fan interlock contacts tied to terminals R and G inside the hood seen here. The terminals are dry with no voltage and connected to a normally open contact that closes when the supply fan should run. These connections can be used to drive a device that controls a supply fan if makeup air is necessary. Fire system contact connections are available at terminals C6, NC6, and NO6. C6 and NO6 terminal blocks are dry, normally open contact that closes in the event of a fire. C6 and NC6 are a dry, normally closed contact that opens in the event of a fire. These contacts can be used to activate fire alarms, shunt trip breakers, or other accessories as required in the field. You have now successfully completed an installation of a Greenheck fire-ready residential range hood. For more information about Greenheck, visit greenheck.com. You can also contact our technical support team at 1-800-371-6858. Thank you for choosing Greenheck.